The close support medium regiment is a component of division artillery which provides intimate fire support for the units of a brigade. The regiment can quickly and accurately deliver a large weight of fire close in front of our own troops and can switch its fire rapidly from one target to another over a wide front. In addition, its network of observers provide the brigade commander with an important source of updated information on enemy activities across his front. The regiment is organized into a command group, four close support medium batteries, a target acquisition and support battery, and a headquarters and services battery. The medium batteries are made up of a battery commander's party, a battery command post, four forward observation parties, two firing troops, and a support troop. Each firing troop includes a small command post with its reconnaissance detachment, five self-propelled M109 howitzers, and their ammunition resupply vehicles. The support troop includes an ammunition section, mobile repair teams, refueling and stores detachments, an ambulance, and a kitchen. The target acquisition and support battery comprises a battery headquarters located in the Regimental A echelon area, a target acquisition troop, a rocket troop, and a support troop. The battery commander functions as the brigade artillery intelligence officer and heads up the artillery intelligence cell at brigade headquarters. He and his staff are primarily concerned with the location and silencing of enemy mortars directly affecting formation operations. They use intelligence reports, RPV imagery, radars, and observer reports in their locating activities, and direct the fire of any available guns and rockets to assist with counter-bombardment tasks. The target acquisition troop is organized into a small command post with its integral reconnaissance element, the Brigade Artillery Intelligence Office staff, a survey section, a remotely piloted vehicle section, and a counter-mortar radar section. The troop provides surveillance information, target acquisition, and target engagement support. The survey section has a small command post and five survey pairs. Their main tasks are to provide accurate direction, location, and height data to the gun areas and to equipment groups that will place all fire units and target acquisition elements on a common grid and fix registration and control points. The remotely piloted vehicle section includes a small command post, four launchers, and two ground control stations. It provides target acquisition and surveillance information and target support. The section detaches a liaison and analysis representative to the BAIO cell to assist with data interpretation. The counter-mortar radar section comprises a small command post located near the regimental CP, two counter-mortar radars, and four listening posts. They acquire location information on enemy mortars. They can also be used to adjust artillery fire for the regiment and help direct general support artillery shoots. The listening posts cue the radars, providing coverage through their primary arcs. They may be assisted by the regiment's OPs and the sound-ranging advanced posts of the Division Target Acquisition Battery. The rocket troop includes a command post with a reconnaissance element and five multiple launch rocket detachments. It is used mainly for counter-bombardment and for the delivery of scatterable mines or improved conventional munitions. The support troop is similarly structured to those of the gun batteries. Its replenishment task is complicated by the wide dispersion of its associated elements. please see productions involving the Division Target Acquisition Battery, catalog number 07507A, and the Multiple Launch Rocket Regiment, catalog number 25472D. For further information on the detailed operation of the RPV and MLR elements. The Headquarters and Services Battery is organized into an operations troop comprising a Fire Support Coordination Center and a regimental command post, plus a signals troop, a services troop, and a maintenance troop. The FSCC Group operates a command post for the coordination of all indirect artillery fire supporting the brigade, as well as providing tactical advice to the brigade operations staff. The regimental command post provides the required technical orders to control and coordinate the fire of the guns. The signals troop maintains all communications at regimental level and links to higher headquarters. The batteries and regimental headquarters are interconnected by radio and, when possible, by line. The services and maintenance troops deploy into A and B echelon groups. The regimental A echelon includes the logistics command post, along with supply, stores, and maintenance detachments, and the unit medical station. The regimental B echelon comprises the regimental administrative command post and any elements not required forward. Within the brigade sector, the regiment normally deploys with observers and battery commanders well forward with the battle groups. The guns are located to the rear of the forward troops, about one-third of their range from the FIBA. The two counter-mortar radars are normally sighted well forward and to the flanks of the brigade, with their four listening posts positioned across the brigade front, close to the FIBA. The commanding officer's tactical command group is located at brigade headquarters, along with the Fire Support Coordination Center and the artillery intelligence staff. The multiple launch rocket detachments are dispersed in hides from which they can deploy to cover the brigade front. The regimental A echelon area is located to the rear of the gun areas. The RPV area, with its launchers, ground control stations, and support vehicles, is sighted well rearward of the guns. The B echelon area, including the battery office elements, deploys within the brigade administration area. The regiment's command, liaison, and observation elements deploy with their affiliated supported arm. The commanding officer joins up with the brigade commander, the battery commanders with the battle groups, and the OP parties with the combat teams, where they advise on and coordinate all fire support activities within their assigned boundaries. The commanding officer establishes a tactical command group and a fire support coordination center at the affiliated brigade headquarters location. When not moving with the commander, the CO exercises command of the regiment from the FSCC. He carries out detailed fire support planning for the upcoming battle and coordinates the deployment of all artillery resources placed under command of the brigade. The battery commander's party co-locates with the mortar platoon HQ at the battle group headquarters. It includes drivers, technicians, and signalers, and forms the basis of the battle group's FSCC. The battery commander normally accompanies the commander of the battle group and provides fire planning support advice. Each close support battery deploys four APC-mounted artillery observation parties, each consisting of an officer, observation post technician, and two signaler drivers. The OP is usually located within the combat team's boundaries. Communications and liaison are established with the local commander, An OP normally maintains continuous observation, reporting information and engaging targets that present themselves or which are requested by the supported arms. Binoculars, telescopes, and medium and long-range night observation devices are used as vision aids. Laser range finders are also available for more precise measuring of distances and bearings to targets. Artillery OPs usually cover the main approaches to the brigade area and are integrated into the brigade surveillance and target acquisition plan. Batteries occupy reserved gun areas located to the rear of the forward battle groups, which are allocated by formation headquarters. Each covers an area of approximately one grid square, large enough for F and A echelons of a deployed battery. The regimental command post, with its signal troop and survey detachments, is centrally sited in one of the reserved gun areas so as to provide good communications to the guns and to brigade and division headquarters. The regimental command post officer organizes and directs the activities of the CP. He controls the fire of the regiment and other allotted artillery, monitors and reports on ammunition expenditure, and passes on tactical information. He maintains communications with the commanding officer, the FSCC, and the batteries on two regimental nets, and operates a link to division artillery. The second in command of the regiment, operating from the regimental command post area, directs reconnaissance activities, coordinates the deployment of the regiment, organizes the defense of the gun area, and is assisted by the regimental sergeant major in overseeing the replenishment of ammunition. The battery deploys in a main gun area where it provides indirect fire support within a primary arc, down to a minimum range. The main gun area breaks down into a gun position and an echelon area for the support vehicles and equipment not required forward. It is normally located about 4 to 6 kilometers behind the FIBA. A temporary gun position may be occupied beforehand in order to prevent disclosure of the main position. It may be well forward so that guns can reach targets otherwise out of range, such as when supporting a covering force or carrying out depth fire tasks. Each battery also prepares an alternate gun area, which is occupied if heavy counter-bombardment or infiltration make the main position untenable. In this situation, all elements move to the alternate position as quickly as possible, taking only necessary equipment and stores to reduce casualties of personnel and equipment. The battery gun position consists of an area for the main command post and other headquarters elements. Two troop areas, each containing their 5 guns and the troop CP, and an echelon area containing their ammunition vehicles. Elements are sited to ensure the efficient firing of the guns, to provide protection against ground attack, and to give ready access for ammunition supply vehicles. A dispersed layout allows elements to be deployed 300 to 500 meters apart, with the battery covering the better part of a grid square. It offers the best compromise between reducing vulnerability and the need to maintain effective internal command, control, communications, and local defense. The gun position may also be deployed in a close posture, wherein the troops and guns are located no more than 50 meters apart. This option allows for the optimum command and control over the guns. Urban locations present an additional deployment posture. With the ability of buildings to mask infrared signatures and enhance camouflage, urban deployments may be the preferred means of improving unit survivability. This may occur in spite of the inherent problems of communications, control, and the possible need to accept a lesser separation between gun platforms. Various types of artillery ammunition used by the regiment include high explosive shells and extended range projectiles, which can be fitted with point detonating, delay, or airburst fuses. Carrier shells, which eject the contents through the base of the shell. They can contain fillings of illuminating candles, colored smoke canisters, chemicals, leaflets, and various submunitions. Smoke shells with white phosphorus. Concrete piercing shells, which are used against pillboxes, strong points, buildings, or fortifications. Cannon launch precision guided projectiles, which are used in conjunction with laser designators and employed against stationary or moving targets. Sense and destroy anti-armor projectiles, which are capable of detecting and firing intelligent submunitions at point targets. And free rocket projectiles, which incorporate high explosive and a variety of submunitions. Infiltration of sizable enemy forces may occur unexpectedly, often with little warning of an attack. Batteries are normally deployed independently and must rely on their own resources for local defense. After the technical requirements of sighting the guns have been satisfied, the gun platforms may need to be adjusted to provide adequate security against ground and air attack. The battery's best defense against enemy armor that has penetrated the FIBA is to go silent and attempt to escape detection. Only when necessary would they directly engage enemy tanks or other elements. In addition, arrangements are made with other batteries for support in case of an attack. Camouflage minimizes the possibility of detection and identification. A well-camouflaged position offers flash cover, concealed routes, and maximum concealment from observation. When leaving a position, spade marks and weapon pits should be filled, dumps and trenches closed, and litter hidden. These steps prevent enemy air photos from showing the type of weapon, strength, and departure route of the unit, as well as its deployment profile. Camouflage is an art that, if well applied, can be the difference between effectiveness and survival, or suppression and destruction. The task of the close support regiment is to neutralize or defeat the enemy by quick and accurate indirect fire, or with direct fire when needed, and to help integrate all fire support into combined arms operations. Effective use of artillery demands good liaison and the close cooperation of all fire support and command elements, and the quick and accurate delivery of fire onto the target.